Hello, I'm Father Charles Irvin, a priest from the Diocese of Lansing, Michigan. We are here at St. Francis de Sales Seminary in the Archdiocese of Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Suffering and dying on the cross, our blessed Lord offered the sacrifice that forever reconciles our fallen human nature with God our Father. Not only was he the priest, he was at the same time the victim. Writing to the Colossians, St. Paul presents Christ as the eternal high priest with these words: "He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For in him were created all things in heaven and on earth, the visible and in the invisible, whether thrones or dominions, principalities or powers. All things were created through him and for him." There is only one priesthood, Christ's. There is only one mediator between God and man, Jesus Christ. All of us are united into Christ's priesthood when we receive the holy sacrament of baptism. At the Last Supper, his apostles were, however, set apart in a special way and ordained by Christ when he told them, "Do this and remember me." At that moment, the apostles and their successors were sacramentally united with Christ in offering his one and eternal sacrifice. His sacrifice cannot be repeated. We can, however, repeatedly enter into it. Remembering means making ourselves members of it again. "Do this," he said, "and remember me." This is what a Catholic priest does when he celebrates the Eucharist. By the sacrament of baptism, we all become members of Christ's mystical body here on earth. And those who have been called by God and received the sacrament of holy orders minister to all in persona Christi capitis, in the person of Christ, the eternal high priest and head of the church. This is a specific participation in Christ, just as the sacraments of baptism and confirmation and Holy Communion are likewise specific incorporations into Christ. All of them transfigure us in our very nature, each sacrament in its own way. And the sacrament of Holy Orders transfigures us in its own way.
As we forgive those who trespass against us.
Ordination, nevertheless, gives us a unique gift, namely participation in the mystery of the Lord's Supper, acting in the person of Christ, the head of the church. This is a ministry not of power, but of service. A priest gives us his life in order to give us Christ's sacraments. Without the priest, we have no sacraments.
The blood of Christ.
St. Augustine sums it up nicely when he said, "For you I am a bishop, but with you I am a Christian." And so I pray, paraphrase that here and say to you, "For you I am a priest, but with you I am a Christian." We are here at St. Francis de Sales Seminary in the Archdiocese of Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Please pray for priests and those whom God is calling to the priesthood.